The European coastline, spanning an impressive 68,000 kilometres, serves as a sanctuary for countless species, both large and small. Embarking on a journey of discovery, the European Molecular Biology Laboratory has initiated an expedition of profound significance, traversing European coastlines, or simply TREC. This expedition is not just another research project, but a new era of coastal ecosystems exploration. With more than 70 institutions and a growing number of 150-plus research groups, there is a timely and ambitious goal to observe, model and understand the effects of changing environments on organisms and communities at the cellular and molecular levels.
The idea is really to try and understand how pollutants that often originate from the land get exported into the sea, for example through rain, and how those pollutants are actually going to impact the biology of the ocean. It would be a bit naive to think that, you know, all the herbicides and pesticides, hormones that we use on land would not end up in the sea, and this is exactly what we observe. To really try and understand how the marine microbial community, in particular phytoplankton, is going to be affected by those chemical pollutions that actually come from the land.
For this reason, samples will be collected both in the sea and on land during the expedition. The scientists and researchers on land will take air, soil, sediment, and shallow water samples. The teams will be supported by mobile laboratories on land and local marine research facilities. Collecting samples and data at over 120 locations along the European coast follows a big idea: to realize the first census of European coastal ecosystems.
The TREC sampling happens in different types of sites. We have industrial sites, agricultural sites, urban sites, but also pristine sites. And you can already really see the difference from one place to another.
On the site, we take four different types of sample. So first of all, we set up our air sampling devices. We not only look at the samples in the soil or the ocean, we also sample the air.
These samplers have the filters placed on top of them, so now for the next 4 hours we can collect the bioaerosols. Our collaborators then later can check what's in the air, for example, biodiversity, bacteria.
We move on and take the soil samples, which takes longest because there we have most of the samples. We take the soil and then distribute it for different analysis. For DNA sequencing samples, for imaging, for chemical analysis. We also do the water sampling, which then is followed by a lot of filtrations because we want to have different sizes of organisms in separate samples.
With TREC, the idea is that we collect planktons from each site. We process them, or rather pre-process them, in the advanced mobile labs on site. So we preserve the cells in the freshest condition possible.
More than 70 institutions involved, 150 research groups, and daily increasing. We have so many data at so many scales, at so many locations. This is a gigantic project.
It's definitely not something that one lab can do. It's not something that one institute can do, and it's not something that one country can do. So for me, it's the ambition that makes the project amazing.